Today we'll start with the next lecture in the series for computer graphics for 3D. In this particular area, we shall be discussing how we can make the content interactive by using certain devices, interactive input methods and graphical user input. And this is the topic for today. And we shall be discussing about briefly about how these devices have been incorporated at certain levels in certain softwares like Microsoft Word, PowerPoint and MS Paint and several other types of softwares are there where there is a facility for manipulating the objects of interest. And today's lecture basically deals with a theoretical aspect regarding the interactive input methods. So let us start with the first thing. One of the most important advances in computer technology was enabling the users to interact with the computer displays. Now whatever software that presently is being manufactured or prepared by the companies is the major concern is to prepare GUI based, graphical user interface based types of software where the user can interactively work with the software and it will give him a feel of working with the particular software. And though the majority of the things happen in behind the screen, but the user input is also taken into care so that the user also feels being part of the team. So that is the reason interaction is basically required. In the earlier days when there were command based systems, operating systems like Unix, the users had to remember large number of commands. Now but in the present day environment, if we talk about say Linux or if you talk about Windows latest operating systems nowadays available, if you want to boot those systems through a CD or a DVD, we shall be able to see that interactively we can enter the information and automatically the windows appear in front of us and we need not remember any type of commands. That is the most important thing that present day environment has helped us in learning. It was Ivan Sutherland's project Sketchpad launched the present era of interactive computer graphics. Sketchpad was the first interactive program since 1963 when this work was published. There have been many advances in both hardware and the software, but the viewpoint ideas he introduced still dominate the computer graphics. Actually, the kind of work he did, he wanted to have an interactive system in which the user will give certain sort of input and the system will work upon those inputs and will show the results immediately in front of the user on the monitors. So that was the basic reason why this interactive computer graphics process was started. Now let us talk about say the input devices. From the physical perspective, each device has properties that make it more suitable for certain tasks than for others. Now for example, there are varieties of devices available with us. For example, mouse is there. It helps in clicking. It helps in moving or it helps in grasping or grappling the positions on the monitor. Now the coordinate values can be grabbed very easily with the help of mouse, though it can be done with the help of command also, but this work becomes faster and easier to handle if you use certain particular type of devices for which they have been made for. Now there are two primary types of physical devices. One is pointing device and another one is the keyboard device. In the case of pointing devices, let us start with the input devices. The pointing devices allow the users to indicate a position on the screen and almost always incorporates one or more buttons. The keyboard device is almost always a physical keyboard, but it can be generalized to include any device that returns a character code to a program. Now these pointing devices like your mouse is there. Suppose you want to close a window, there is an option at the extreme right hand corner provided. There is a cross there, there is a box there and there is another dash there. Now suppose you click at the cross, that means you are trying to bring the mouse or the cursor at that particular location so that that indicates And when you press that mouse at that particular location, it means that interactively you want to close that window. You no longer want to see that window in front of you. Now suppose you use the you are having a small window and you want to enlarge the size of the window. That means there is a option available at the middle, that is the box is there. You click that box, automatically the window becomes larger in size. And if you want to minimize, then there is also an option here. So therefore we have an option for minimization, maximization and closing of the windows. The keyboard devices, like the keyboard we have, it enters the information in ASCII character code inside the computer, and that information is being processed by the program. Let us see this kind of devices, pointing devices that can be used in two subcategories: relative position devices, absolute position devices. Now these are relative position devices and these are absolute devices, with the help of which the user will be able to provide inputs. Now other pointing devices are joysticks, space balls, etc. The two major characteristics describe the logical behavior of an input device: what measurements the device returns to the user program, when the device returns those measurements. Some of the APIs such as FIX and GTS consider six classes of logical input devices, and OpenGL, which is an open graphical language, does not follow this type of approach, but we will look at these classified briefly and see how OpenGL provides similar types of functionality. Let us see this. Yeah, the first one is a device that provides ASCII strings to the user program. Most windowing systems and OpenGL do not distinguish between logical string and device and the keyboards. In the second case, we have the locators, a device that provides the position in the world coordinates to the user program. It usually implemented via pointing device such as mouse or a trackball. In the OpenGL, we usually have to do the conversion from screen coordinates to the world coordinates within our own programs. A device that returns the identifier of an object to the user program, usually implemented with the same device as a locator but has separate software for it. In OpenGL, we can use the process called selection to accomplish the picking. Choice: a device that allows the user to select one of discrete number of options. In OpenGL, we can have various widgets provided by the windowing system. Dial provides analog input to the user program. Here again, widgets provide this facility through graphical devices such as slide bars. Stroke: a device that returns an array of locations through, although we can think of stroke as a similar to multiple locators, it is often implemented such as that a fraction, such as pushing down a mouse button, starts the transfer of data into a specified array, and a second action, such as the releasing of the button, ends the transfer. Suppose we want to transfer this from one limit to the other limit, so we can do that with the help of strokes. Next is the measure and trigger. The manner by which the physical and the logical input devices provide input to an application program can be described in terms of two entities. Now we are measuring the information with the help of the devices. Now what kind of information, or what kind of, how the two entities are dealt? One is called as measure, another one is called the trigger. Now measure is what is returned, trigger when it is returned. Now triggering takes place at a particular period of time, so that is why trigger is time based. Measure can also include status information. We can obtain the measure of a device in three distinct modes. Each mode is defined by the relationship between the measure process and the trigger. The three modes are request mode, sample mode, and event mode. In the case of request mode, the image of the device is not returned to the program until the device is triggered. This mode is centered in non-graphical applications such as typical C programs. Input is buffered until the trigger is hit. So what happens? We have a statement in the OC environment, or in Z we have scanf. The scanf, the trigger is the enter key. After you press the enter key in the program, then only the output, the input will be taken up, and then further processing will take place. Now the sample mode, the input is immediate. As soon as the function call in the user program is encountered, the measure is returned. Both request mode and sample mode are useful for situations where the program guides the user, but are not useful in the applications where the user controls the flow of the program, like the flight simulators. Now, in the case of event mode, each time a device is triggered, an event is generated and placed into the event queue. This is the trigger process, trigger, and the major process, major, event queue. And event will happen, program will return, and await. It waits for that queue results. The program can get events of the queue and service them. Associate a callback function with specific type of event. And when that event comes to the front of the queue, that function is automatically executed, as shown in the diagram here. Now the next thing, that is the clients and the servers. Here also the data exchange takes place, and GUI based type of systems have a role to play. Now you can see that all these components are attached in the network, and there are several types of devices that have been shown here. Now server is something that can perform tasks of clients, and clients and servers can be distributed over a network of and contains within the computational unit. Now we can have the interaction techniques. Let us revise them again. The interactive data can be done through locators, a device for specifying the coordinate positions x and y, stroke, a device for specifying the series of coordinate positions, track ball, mouse, space ball, etc. In the case of this, we have light pens, keyboard, etc. locators. String, a device specifying the text input. For example, text can be done with the help of keyboards. Then we have valuators, a device for specifying scalar value for rotation, scale, factor, numerical pads, joysticks, and track balls. Choice, a device for selecting menu options, mouse, keyboards, touch panels. Pick, a device for selecting picture components, mouse and joysticks. Now this is all we have done in the first section of this particular topic, and here we are pointing out about six devices, six types of different devices. One is the locator, and another one is the stroke, and next is the string, then we have valuator, then choice, and then pick. In the case of locator, so we are locating the position of x and y on the coordinate values, and stroke also used for finding out the coordinate positions x and y with the help of trackballs, mouse, baseballs. And in the case, string is a group of characters together. They can be entered with the help of keyboards. And valuators is a device for specifying the rotation scaling values through numerical pads, joysticks, and all those. Choice is a device for selecting choice lists. For example, suppose you are filling up a form, then you want to select a drop down menu or some particular thing. Say that can be done with the help of mouse, keyboard, cursor keys, and touch panels. Pick, a device for selecting the picture components. For example, suppose you want to select a particular region of interest, ROI, that is called the region of interest in an image, that can be captured with the help of the pick kind of devices, that is the select options will be there. Now, interactive picture construction techniques. There are several techniques that are incorporated into graphics packages to aid the interactive construction of pictures. Various input options can be provided so that coordinate information entered with the locator and the stroke devices can be adjusted or interpreted according to a selected option. So what is the need for interactive picture construction is to have so that the stroke devices can be adjusted or interpreted according to a selected option. Now overall changes can be brought about into the system. For example, we can restrict all the lines to be either horizontal or vertical. Input coordinates can be established, the positions or boundaries for our object to be drawn, or they can be used to rearrange the previously displayed objects. For example, dragging, dropping, if you want to say suppose you have a group of objects and you want to place them in a special position, say for example three objects should be placed in the first row, two objects should be placed in the second row. So you can bring about a change by moving them, dragging them. Okay, so this can be this can make the overall interactions interactive. Now basic positioning methods, coordinate values supplied by the locator are often used for positioning methods to specify the location for displaying an object to or a characteristic. Now these particular devices will help you in where do you want to place those objects, or where do you want to place the particular text onto the screen area. So that can be done with the help of this coordinate values. We interactively select coordinate positions with appointing device, usually by positioning the screen cursor. Just how the object or state position is performed depends on the selected options. With a text string, for example, the screen point could be taken as the center of the position, or the start or end of the position string, or any other string position. Options can be discussed. For example, suppose we want to draw or we want to write from this particular location. So this particular location x and y values must be specified in that particular string function that you want to display. Now for lines, straight line segments can be displayed between two selected screen positions as an aid for positioning objects. Numerical values for selected positions can be echoed onto the screen also. Yeah, this can be done. Using echoed coordinate values as a guide, we can make adjustments in the selected location to obtain accurate positioning. Now, if we can make adjustments in the selected locations to obtain accurate positioning. Suppose we want to fix up a particular text at a particular point, so this can be done. The constraints. Now what are constraints? Are set of rules. So what kind of rules are there? With some applications, certain types of prescribed orientations or object alignments are useful. A constraint is a rule for altering input coordinate values to produce a specified orientation or alignment of the displayed coordinates. Now a constraint is a rule for altering input coordinate values to produce a specified orientation or alignment of displayed coordinates. The displayed coordinates can be changed, or they can be displayed in a differential manner by applying certain set of rules. There are many kinds of constraint functions that can be specified, but the most common constraint is horizontal or vertical alignment of straight lines. Now suppose you want to draw a line, the particular options will be horizontally or vertically or angular, whatever the option that you are giving the rule. With this constraint, we can create horizontal or vertical lines without worrying about the precise specification about the end coordinates. Now, in this particular case, if you specify that you want to draw only the horizontal lines, in that case, it will be drawing the horizontal lines. And if you have specified in the rule that it is the vertical line, so you just give the points, automatically the line will be in front of you. A horizontal or vertical constraint is implemented by determining whether any two input coordinate endpoints are more nearly horizontal or more nearly vertical. So, in the difference in x and y values of the two endpoints is smaller, the difference in x and y values, a horizontal line is displayed. Otherwise, a vertical line is long. Other kinds of constraints can be applied to input coordinates to produce a variety of alignments. Lines could be constrained to have a particular slant, such as 45 degree. And input coordinates could be constrained to lie along defined paths, such as circular arcs. So, for example, suppose you want to you have drawn a graph and you have placed these values. Now, these markers can be at particular angle. Suppose you want to have this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. They are at particular angle. Now, they can be in the horizontal also. Say, so 1, 2, 3, 4. So say suppose this kind of graph is there, and these particular set of values depend upon what kind of arrangement do you want for that particular figure. Constraints. Continue, press the button here, and you will see that there are several options in the software available. You can press the button and then drag. This is this this way you will get starting position and ending position. If you drag it, and then automatically the line is drawn in front of you. Second position is there. And similarly in this case, we have suppose we want to draw a particular vertical line. We can have we want to draw a vertical line from this point as shown here. Dragging it, it automatically draws the line. So there are majority of softwares with the help of which you can draw such type of lines. You can see the Microsoft Word has got the particular type of options available, and the same kind of options are available, say suppose in the case of Excel, PowerPoint and all those. MS Paint also has such provisions for drawing such type of lines, objects, etc. And they can be specifically dragged and dropped onto the screen area. Even in the case of Microsoft Word, there are several kinds of arrows and several kinds of objects that can be drawn by pulling them onto the screen area. So that depends upon the kind of starting point and the ending point of the particular object. Now in this particular case, positioning is very very important here. Suppose you want to position a particular kind of device, that object that you want to construct, and you want to position at this particular location, the object will be displayed in that position. Now grids, this again we have labeling can also be done, text can also be done. We can drag and drop the line in this way also, which is possible. Grids, now the kind of zigzag graph type of structure that appears on the figures. Another kind of constraint is a grid of rectangular lines displayed in some part of the section screen area. When the grid is used, any input coordinate position is rounded to the nearest intersection of the two grid lines. Figures illustrate line drawing with a grid. Each of the two cursor positions is shifted to the nearest grid intersection point, and a line is drawn between these grid points. Grid facilitate objects constructions because a new line can be joined easily to a previously drawn line by selecting any position near the endpoint grid line sections of one of the displayed lines. Spacing between the grid lines is often an option that can be set by the user. Similarly, the grids can be turned on or off. For example, in MATLAB it is possible. There is a command called grid on. Grid on. And similarly, we have a command called grid off. So, these options can be switched on or off as per the requirements. Now grids here, it is shown here, grids, and you can pull, drag and drop from this particular location. Suppose you want to draw this way, and the line has been shown this way. Now gravity field, in the construction of the figures, we sometimes need to connect lines at positions between endpoints. Since the exact positioning of the screen cursor at the connecting point can be difficult, graphic strategies can be designed to convert any input position near the line to a position on the line. For example, suppose if we talk about say Excel, there's a, if you have filled up a cell and you want to fill all the cells with particular value, there is a plus sign or that appears, small plus sign appears at this particular point. You drag it, automatically all the cells will have the same value here, or the formula will be copied onto all the cells. Now this type of options can be done with the help of a certain appearance of characters, gravity fields at the end points. Suppose you have drawn a line like this, and you want to join a line in the center. Suppose one of the software points point here, then the plus sign will appear. You can join the line from this point to this point. So this type of things can be done with the help of gravity field. Gravity field area is illustrated with the shaded boundary shown in the figure. Areas around the endpoints are enlarged to make it easier for us to connect the lines at positions on the line and with their endpoints. Selected positions in one of the circular areas of the gravity field are attracted to the endpoint in that area. The size of the gravity fields is chosen large enough to aid positioning, but small enough to reduce the chances of overlap with other lines. In many lines are displayed, gravity areas can overlap, and it may be difficult to specify points correctly, because the reason is the cursor will be appearing in this particular location, and say suppose another line is already there, so you have to decide which point is being joined by this particular set of lines. So in this case, the gravity field method helps in identifying the endpoints of the required objects. For example, here we have the endpoints have been shown as with gravity. Now this the next new line can be easily joined to this point. Suppose you want to join this point with this point, we can have this type of things. Now the next is the rubber band method. Rubber band method is the straight lines can be constructed and positioned using rubber band methods, which stretch out line from starting position as the screen cursor is moved. Now figure demonstrates the rubber band method. Rubber band method is like the stretching of a rubber band. Now can we create such type of software packages with the help of which we will be able to drag the object, and the respective size will be according like the just like the rubber band. Finally, select the second position on the screen and endpoint is there. Rubber band methods are used to construct and position other objects besides straight lines. Okay, there are several types of objects which can be constructed with the help of rubber band methods. The property remains that they can be stretched, their size will increase in size. The size of the object will increase, and if you specify location is there, and you can drag and it will become like this. So if we have a circle, if we pull it and like a rubber band method, it will turn into an ellipse. We can see very easily. Now next is, this is the representation for the rubber bands, and dragging also is possible. Here next is the dragging. A technique that is often used in an interactive picture construction is to move the objects into position by dragging them with the screen cursor. We first select an object. For example, suppose you want to draw a rectangle onto a particular area, you will select that option and automatically you will move to that particular area of the screen where you want to place that object, or specific location is specified. And then just by dragging, you will be able to see that the things appears in front of you. And next is the dragging. We have here, suppose this is the object here, this diagram shows linearly this object is being moved second position, third position, fourth position, and then finally it is being placed over this. So this can be done with the help of dragging. You can see the next set of objects also, press buttons, and we have here dragging. This is there, when we go on dragging, this is the size of the arc goes on increasing. Here we drag, it becomes this way. Now sketching can also be done, freehand lines, it is possible to draw lines, for example, in the particular tables or in the particular objects or pictures, we can draw certain specific types of lines. Painting and drawing options are for sketching, sketching, drawing, and painting comes in a variety of forms. Straight lines, polygon, circles can be generated with methods discussed in the previous section. Curve drawing options can be provided using standard curve shapes such as circular arcs, or with freehand sketching is also possible. Some softwares will provide freehand sketching for things to be done. Line widths can be specified, line size can be specified, attributes, options can also be specified in the similar way in the case of drawing of objects. Now scales and guidelines can also be there. Scales and guidelines are some sort of information provided to the user that this much size of object by dragging has been obtained. So this can be shown here in the next slide. You can see that by dragging here this way, you can get the scale is also appearing in front of you. This is a sort of a guide. Positioning is also there. Then labeling, position text, dimensioning techniques, etc. So in this particular today's lecture, we have briefly discussed about the six different types of input devices and how they have been categorized and what are the ways with the help of which you can make the interactive picture construction methods. This is all for today. Thank you.